Now, a lot of what I would call work in my job, you know, the things I don't like doing, is simple simulation of productivity, bureaucratic simulation, created by kind of managerialists whose job, the kind of parasites of institutions, the real parasites, not immigrants, not people claiming unemployment benefit, the real parasites of our society, the very high earners who propagate all this stuff to keep us in a state of panicked anxiety, so and radical competitive individualism, such that we can't act together and gain a collective agency. You know, and so the big lie that has been sold to us by neoliberalism is that if we withdraw security from people, withdraw kind of social security, then suddenly there'll be this creative, this wellspring of creativity will just emerge. Okay, well, all that happens if you remove security from people is they get like I was when I was self-employed. All of their creative energy goes into how can I make money. That's the energy of the society. That's a stupid thing for people to have to think about a lot of the time. You know, and look at all these great people we're supposed to admire now. Not that they've invented anything. You know, Steve Jobs, he didn't invent anything. He's just a parasite. You know, Simon Cowell, he doesn't have done anything. He's just a parasite. What are these people good at? They're just good at making money. And that should be enough reward, right? If you want to make, if that's what you want to devote your life to, just fucking do it. But don't expect us to also admire you and just, you know, you be the model for everybody else all the time. You know, we shouldn't have to worry about making money every waking hour of our days. That's a depressing kind of reality that has been artificially imposed on us. I mean, we can break out of that. Is this privatization of stress? It's normalized. Like, you know, the fact that young people are depressed, who gives a shit? You know, like, this is the idea. Young people are depressed, that's just part of life. It wasn't part of life. Like, it was not part of life. The increase of the depression amongst young people is shocking. And, you know, that ought to be the biggest possible indicator and condemnation of the world in which we're now living. It wasn't normal for young people to be depressed in the 70s, let's say. Got to start off from that heroic conditions in which young people live. These are terrible conditions. Just really, really terrible conditions. I just can't impress this. You've been deprived of things. You've been deprived of things, and the things that you've been deprived of are being sold to you as benefits. It's a great new world. You've got all this stuff. You've got all this capacity to do things. It just isn't like that. And so for Berardi, the argument is, why did 90s was a decade of the emergence of cyberspace and of Prozac? And for him, those two things are totally related together. How did people cope with these new level of demands that were placed upon them? They started to take antidepressants, which are now very common, particularly amongst young people, antidepressants as a hazing thing. Which you can hear this like this downer haze. That's why Drake is really interesting. The new Drake record, full of this kind of electro downer haze. Everyone's on downers now to cope with just cyber blitz, whether it's antidepressants or other forms of kind of self-medication in order to cope with this. There's a breakdown at the end of the 90s, according to Berardi. There will be a breakdown. We cannot cope with this. We cannot cope with this.